My dear brothers, at the end, at the back, please pay attention. Now the strength of an elephant is not only in its size, but when a group of elephants find some problem somewhere, they can communicate to the other group of their elephants silently at a very low frequency, informing them, warning them about the danger, so that they don't come that side. Do you know that? That is their one of the strengths. Now you must be wondering, before answering this question, why I am asking these questions to you. Similarly, now next question is, how many of you know your strengths? Many of you may not. But this weakness and strength are, you should be knowing about yourself. You all have weaknesses, you all have talents, you all have strengths, but you should know. Similarly, that animals what I spoke, you also have strengths. Now for the strengths, first you have to know what talents you have. You nurture those talents into a skill, put in hard work, and then that particular talent becomes your strength. So वीकनेस जानना जरूरी है और अपना स्ट्रेंथ जानना भी जरूरी है. इफ यू नो योर स्ट्रेंथ देन इट विल हेल्प यू इन मेकिंग योर लिविंग यूजिंग दैट स्ट्रेंथ यू सो दैट यू कैन सपोर्ट योरसेल्फ एंड टू योर फैमिली. ओके, सो एवरी इंडिविजुअल हैज टू लुक इन टू देमसेल्फ्स टू फाइंड देयर ओन स्ट्रेंथ. विवेकानंद ऑल्सो फाउंड द स्ट्रेंथ इन हिम and it got doubly clarified when he went to Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. So similarly, you look into yourself, and when you have a doubt, go to your teachers, go to your parents, they will tell you what your strengths are, and then you can work upon that.
हमें दैनिक जीवन में आचरण करते हैं तब जब परिस्थितियां आचरण के विपरीत हो जाती है तो हमें इस कठिनाई हमें कठिनाई महसूस होती है जिससे हम आचरण पथ से विचलित हो जाते हैं. ऐसी स्थिति में हमें अटल बने रखने के लिए क्या करना चाहिए, इसका मार्गदर्शन दीजिए. स्वामी जी के साहित्य के अध्ययन क्या उपकारी हो सकता है? आज सवेरे का क्लास हम लोग सुने हैं सोमनाथ दादा का, उससे शायद आप आइडिया मिला होगा कि कैसे हम विल पावर को बढ़ा सकते हैं. आपका जो प्रश्न है वो तो इच्छा शक्ति कैसे बढ़ाया जाए, यही आप जानना चाहते हैं. तो उसके लिए इन्होंने आज सवेरे में एक ऑटो सजेशन चार्ट किया है. हम लोगों को मन में इतनी शक्ति है, व्हाट ए माइंड कैन बिलीव एंड कंसीव इट कैन अचीव. अगर हम अपने मन को बार बार सजेस्ट करें कि हमको अच्छा मनुष्य बनना है तो हम हमारी जो इच्छा शक्ति है वो बढ़ जाएगी. इसीलिए स्वामी जी बोलते थे शिक्षा क्या है, क्या वह पुस्तक विद्या है? नहीं. क्या वह नाना प्रकार का ज्ञान है? नहीं. जिस प्रशिक्षण के द्वारा इच्छा शक्ति को के प्रवाह को वश में लाया जाता है और वह फलदायी होता है उसे शिक्षा कहते हैं. तो यही प्रशिक्षण हम लोग यहाँ देना चाह रहे हैं. और तो सजेशन एक आजकल पाश्चात्य जगत में इसका बहुत वैल्यू हो, सभी लोग इसको मान रहे हैं कि मन में अनंत शक्ति है. और अगर मन में कोई चीज ठान लिया जाए, मन अगर संकल्प कर ले तो उसको हम लोग प्राप्त कर सकते हैं. हम लोग अगर अपने विल पावर में ठान लेंगे कि हमारे भीतर में सभी के भीतर में प्रत्येक आत्मा अव्यक्त ब्रह्म है, सबके भीतर पोटेंशियली एक डिवाइन है, इज पोटेंशियली डिवाइन, डिविनिटी हमारे भीतर में, लेकिन उसको व्यक्त करने के लिए टीचर जो यहाँ है वो आपको खींच के नंबर नहीं कर सकते. आपको उपाय बता दिए कि ऑटो सजेशन आपको रोज सुबह शाम करना है, उसका रिजल्ट विदिन 6 महीने आप देखेंगे कि जैसे सूरज पूरब में निकलता निश्चित है, तो चमत्कार है. आप खुद अनुभव करेंगे कि आपके अंदर के जितने अच्छे गुण हैं वे सब बाहर व्यक्त हो रहे हैं और आपके जीवन में एक रूपांतरण होगा और आप सभी कठिनाइयों पर विजय प्राप्त कर सकते हैं. जो इनका हम लोगों को आज मिला है यहाँ से एक प्रशिक्षण हुआ का, कैसे हम अपना सेल्फ रेवल्यूशन करेंगे, अपने आप का हम आत्म मूल्यांकन करेंगे। आप यहाँ से जाने के बाद आज 9 तारीख है, आप 16 तारीख का डेट में अगर आप देखिएगा तो कौन कौन गुण का मानांक आपके पास कितना आया, उसको जरूर कुछ वृद्धि हुई होगी। अपना मानांक और धीरे धीरे बढ़ाते जाएंगे और आपके आचरण में जरूर परिवर्तन आएगा।
टी योगी कुमार, बैच नंबर 11। बैच नंबर 216 के दिनेश कुमार। बैच नंबर 98 नहीं है सर।
प्रकाश बरेत यहाँ पे हैं, इनका प्रश्न है, हम जानते हैं कि हमें अपने लक्ष्य को प्राप्त करने के लिए रोज कुछ ना कुछ तैयारी करनी चाहिए, पर हमें कैसे पता चलेगा कि हम जो जितना तैयारी कर रहे हैं वह हमारे लक्ष्य के लिए काफी है या नहीं। नाउ आई ट्रांसलेट दिस क्वेश्चन टू इन इंग्लिश। दिस ओम प्रकाश बरेत सेज ही वॉन्ट्स टू नो that whatever aim he has made in life, is it right, and how will he get to know whether he is moving in the right direction? So my dear brothers, every individual should have an aim in life, a goal in life, an aspiration in life. So once you have a goal, that goal can be a long-term goal, and to achieve that long-term goal, you have to break that goal into different levels depending upon its intensity and depending upon its time. Suppose, एक example के तौर पे मैं आपको ये बताना चाहूँगा, अगर आप में से किसी को इस उम्र में पढ़ाई लिखाई पे जोर देना है और आगे आप कुछ बनना चाहते हैं, एक अच्छा एग्जांपल ले लेते हैं, सपोज आप में से कोई एक आईएएस आईपीएस बनना चाहता है, तो उस गोल और को मीट करने के लिए ये सिर्फ सोचना कि मैं बन जाऊंगा काफी नहीं है, उसको बनने के लिए, उस पड़ाव को पहुंच छूने के लिए, I mean, to achieve that goal, you have to first plan your complete journey at different levels. If you are right now in say 10th standard or 11th standard or in graduation, you have to focus what all are required. Once you know what is required, then you have to work for it and gather it and work on it. And you have to put time schedules. That okay, next first year of graduation I have to work on this much, second year I'll have to work on this much, third year I'll have to work on this much, and once you are eligible for writing that exam, you are completely prepared to attempt that main exam at that time. So, agar aapko ye pata karna hai, if you want to know whether you are in the right direction or not, yes, certainly if you have a good plan in front of you, which can be made by yourself or in consultation with your gurus and friends, and then it is very clear, okay, whether you have achieved that much or not. If you have achieved it, you will go to the next step. If you have not achieved it, you will work harder to get that and close up on the lost time. I mean, this is how you have to plan it and see that yourself are heading in the right direction or not. You can always consult your peer friends, peer group, teachers and seniors in case you have any doubt. I hope I have answered the question.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Anil Kumar, batch number 251. Yes, Anil Kumar. Oh. What is the use of Yuva Mahamandal certificate in future? After a training course, in every world a certificate is being given, is it? You have completed one course, training course. Any jail, not in Mahamandal, any other else, any other place, you will get a certificate. But you want to know what is value. The certificates are being given as a token that you have successfully completed the training course. You heard in the class of aims and objects of Mahamandal that Mahamandal holds an annual youth training camp every year, Akhil Bharat Vivekananda Yuva Mahamandal, of a duration of 6 days every year from 25th December to 30th December. And one of the boys, he has also attended that training camp. And after successful completion of the training camp, one certificate, just Mahamandal certificate you ask about which was given to him. And after few months, he got a chance and he was asked to appear before a selection committee of a multinational company for interview, along with his all credentials. And he got all his educational certificates, school level examination with so much percentage, in a higher school, college, so much percentage. And then he saw one certificate was there mentioning he has attended Mahamandal, Akhil Bharat Vivekananda Yuva Mahamandal's annual training camp, and he has successfully conducted the classes of character building. And seeing this, the chairman of the screening committee asked, "You have completed this course?" "Yes, I have completed this course a few months ago." "Tell me, what do you mean by character?" And the boy explained what his knowledge about character. "If you are appointed in my company, you will serve what you say character means. Do good, you will serve company with full honesty, dignity, efficiency, because this will show your real character." "Definitely, definitely I will show, because after getting this course in the annual training camp of Akhil Bharat Vivekananda Yuva Mahamandal, last 6-7 months, I am practicing the method, and I am very much hopeful that I will do my duty. It is my duty to perform my duty with fullest honesty, full of honesty, full of efficiency, full of hard work, etc., etc." And immediately the chairman said, "You are good. Please wait outside. I will give you the appointment letter right now." Because it appears to be, other is coming and saying, "I have passed this course, I have passed this course, I possess so much knowledge." But the chairman of the screening committee wants the boy who I am going to appoint in my committee. He is promising that he will serve us committee, serve this company with fullest of his honesty, fullest of his hard labor, fullest of his integrity. This is something unique, appears to be in the mind of that chairman of the steering committee. Generally, after completion of any training course, a circular is given. But sometimes it means a lot. Understand?
Badge number 262, G. Uday Kumar. Badge number 262, G. Uday Kumar. G. Uday Kumar. Y. Abhinay.
Badge number 216, K. Dinesh Kamal.
Any more posture who is present here, they can also ask. Who are present, they can
ask. I am calling all the questions with me, but only one or two person has there.
So any questions you want to ask, you can send your clip here.
Badge number 259, 259. Unara, 259. And badge number 134, CH Vasu. Okay, Vasu. And this badge number 259, both the questions are related to each other. I'll read the question first. They have written this question in Telugu. I'll read it in Telugu, then I'll translate it in English. Manamu chadivinappudu leda manam chadavalani ishtapadi koorchunnappudu మనము ఇతరులు ఏమి చేస్తున్నారు అని అలా చూస్తూ ఉంటాం. అది పోవాలి అంటే ఏమి చేయాలి? హీ సేస్ దట్ వెన్ ఎవర్ హీ సేస్ ఫర్ స్టడీ విత్ హోల్ హార్టెడ్లీ ఇన్స్టెడ్ ఆఫ్ స్టడీ హీ బాదర్డ్ హీ గెట్స్ బాదర్డ్ అబౌట్ వాట్ ఈస్ ది అదర్ చాప్ స్టడీ అండ్ దట్ ఈస్ హౌ హీ గెట్ డిస్ట్రాక్టెడ్ సో వాట్ టు డూ టు అవాయిడ్ సచ్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ఎ డిస్ట్రాక్షన్. Another question which Brother Vasu has asked. Sir, ee rojulo yuvata chedu margadam padutundi. Enduku aa margamlo yuvata vellakunda unde jagratalu emiti? He says, nowadays the youth are heading towards wrong directions in life. Why is it so? And what should be done to avoid it? I thought that this is the main question, but I thought the second question, which is related to studies, is more or less the reasons are same. Now the thing is, my dear brothers, you are going through a phase of life when the world around you has got so much of attractions. These attractions are captured by your mind because of your five senses. You must understand that these five senses are only good for your survival. They do not show you the right world. They do not have the capacity, these senses do not have the capacity to actually understand what the external life is, because you have a limitation. Your eyes cannot see beyond something, your ears cannot hear beyond something, your senses, your taste has a limitation. So when you are perceiving this life with a limitation, you will see a limited life. So what is there actually is not true. Now since you are perceiving the wrong thing, with your thoughts going all around, you make up all those thoughts in your mind which are of no consequence to you. I will tell you a fact that in the present days, each one of you go through 60 to 70,000 thoughts in a day, in a period of 24 hours. A mind of yours is processing 60 to 70,000 thoughts. Now you imagine what will happen to your mind, what is to be received, what is to be kept inside, you do not know. For example, you have a mobile. When your mobile memory gets filled up, what do you do? What do you do when your memory gets filled up? Yes, you erase something which is not useful to you. You don't delete everything. Similarly, these thoughts are occupying your memory inside. And because of this, unnecessary data getting captured, your memory is getting filled up with all kinds of nonsense information. How do we resolve this? Will be the next question. I want all of you to take note of one thing on a daily basis. Be conscious about your surroundings and what you are seeing, what you are hearing. There is a saying by Gandhiji, Bura mat dekho, bura mat suno, bura mat bolo. All these three things have got some importance, because when you put your mind into this with unnecessary data, your mind gets filled up. And all those unnecessary thoughts will not let you go anywhere. This will create a problem when you are sitting for studies. What you can study in half an hour, you are unable to concentrate and sit in the front of book for hours together, because your mind takes you always what is happening on the other room, or what is somebody else doing, what are your friends doing, and things like that. So how do we overcome all this? There is only one method. Even Vivekananda, Swami Vivekananda, also used to practice this method very, very sincerely, very, very regularly, without fail. And that method is meditation. If anyone who can spend 30 minutes every day on meditation, then automatically all these wrong thoughts which your mind is going through on a daily basis over a period of the day, that will certainly will come down. The meditation will help you in absorbing things what you want to learn at this stage in the right thing. Okay. So this meditation is nothing but your mental concentration. Once you practice mental concentration, automatically things will happen. So for answers to both the questions is this, that thoughts will bother you.
Generally at the beginning, we have suggested that for mental concentration, 30 minutes mental concentration to a beginner is very hard thing. It is very, even an older man who is practicing this, 30 minutes mental concentration is a very, very hard thing. So we have suggested that it should be limited to 5-6 minutes. Because if we try for 30 minutes, 40 minutes, we cannot concentrate. Our mind will go to a from this object to another object, from another object to third object. So we have, in the class of mental concentration, it is been told that we should concentrate our mind in one object maximum twice a day, in the morning and in the evening, and it should not be for so 30 minutes, 40 minutes. It should be at the beginning, it should be limited to 4 to 5 minutes or like that. Because 30 minutes concentration at the beginning, it is not impossible, so they will give up this practice. Oh, I cannot concentrate for 30 minutes, so it is not possible for me. But 4-5 minutes he can try to concentrate, and will yield result, and slowly he could improve this concentration. Who is S. Krishna? He has not written the Bell's Dhamma. S. Krishna? That is Sai Krishna. He wants to know character and attitude. About character and attitude. Character, what character means? Character means, character is the generally reflected to our behavior. Okay. And how this character grows? Character, when we do any work or think about anything, it has an impression in our mind. When we repeatedly do this thing, it becomes our habit. I repeated this for a long time, it becomes a sanskar or propensity. What does it mean? In similar occasion, this habit will guide us what to do. Generally, we do not think what to do or not to do. According to our habit, we behave. So this, our behavior represents my character. Attitude is something else. Attitude is the vision for working. That is my attitude. My attitude to this is about my vision about this particular thing. That is called attitude. Okay. Character. What is character? Character is the bundle of habits. Our bundle of habits, the total bundle, we have many habits. That bundle of habits is our character. And attitude is a particular, our vision about a particular thing. That is our attitude to this matter. Okay. Activities mental concentration to a beginner is very hard thing. It is very, even an older man who is practicing this, 30 minutes mental concentration is a very, very hard thing. So we have suggested that it should be limited to 5-6 minutes. Because if we try for 30 minutes, 40 minutes, we cannot concentrate. Our mind will go to a, from this object to another object, from another object to third object. So we have, in the class of mental concentration, it is being told that we should concentrate our mind in one object maximum twice a day, in the morning and in the evening, and it should not be for so 30 minutes, 40 minutes, it should be at the beginning, it should be limited to 4 to 5 minutes or like that. Because 30 minutes concentration at the beginning, it is not impossible. So they will give up this practice. Oh, I cannot concentrate for 30 minutes. So it is not possible for me. But 4 to 5 minutes, he can try to concentrate and will yield result, and slowly he could improve this concentration for him. S. Krishna. Who is S. Krishna? He has not written the badge number. S. Krishna. That is Sai Krishna. He wants to know character and attitude. About character and attitude. Character, what character means? Character is the generally reflected to our behavior. Okay. And how this character grows? Character, when we do any work or think about anything, it has an impression in our mind. When we repeatedly do this thing, it becomes our habit. I repeated this for a long time, it becomes a sanskar or propensity. What does it mean? In similar occasion, this habit will guide us what to do. Generally, we do not think what to do and not to do. According to our habit, we behave. So this, our behavior represents my character. Attitude is something else. Attitude is the vision for one thing. That is my attitude. My attitude to this is about my vision about this particular thing. That is called attitude. Okay. Character. What is character? Character is the bundle of habits. Our bundle of habits, the total one, we have many habits. That bundle of habits is our character. And attitude is a particular, our vision about a particular thing. That is our attitude to this matter. Okay?
స్వామి వివేకానంద ఎవరు చూసి ఇన్స్పైర్ అయ్యారు? ఆన్సర్
రెస్పెక్టెడ్ పర్సన్ Vishwanath from Odisha. And my batch number is 96. The respected and intelligent person sitting on the dashboard. I have a question arises in mind. A powerful word, Swamiji. It's a powerful word, Swamiji. It stands before Vivekananda.
Powerful?
Word, Swami.
Powerful? Swami. Word. No, Swami. Word.
Word. Word. Word.
Okay.
So, yes. I have a question. It stands before Vivekananda.
Now, please.
What?
Please hear the answer. Huh? What a Kumar Biswan.
From Odisha.
You are writing, when you, we are writing our name, we are writing like this, Sri Moloy Kumar Biswan.
Yes.
My name is Somnath Bakchi, I am writing Sri Somnath Bakchi.
Right.
Okay?
Right.
But when a man becomes a sannyasi, he used his name, another name, that is his sannyas name. And Swami means he is respected. He is not using Sri. Swami of Om. Jaise in the camp was inaugurated by Maharaj, we are introducing him. Now the next speaker is Swami. That is why this Swami. Swami means respected. Yeah.
ఎలా అనుకుంటారు
అనుకుంటున్నారు వైకుంఠ రావు హుయిస్ వెస్ నంబర్ 225 వాట్ ఈస్ ద వే టు ఇంప్రూవ్ అవర్ నాలెడ్జ్ ఇంప్రూవ్ ఈ పూయి try to improve our knowledge. Now, knowledge is of two types. One is knowledge that is to know something. And this knowledge can be improved. Our knowledge can be, we could improve our knowledge by reading more and more things. That is something what we, some information we gather from this reading books. And another knowledge is knowledge to form my life. There is two part of education. One is informative, another is formative. Informative means varieties types of information
That is being, I can gather from reading many types of books, many information about science, about literature, about history, about geography. More and more books we can read, we could know more and more information about this subject. That is one type, that is called informative knowledge. And another is formative. Formative means the knowledge which forms us, which forms our life, which forms our character. That means that is something, some good qualities. If we know something good qualities, we think over these qualities and we try to adopt these qualities in our daily life, then this knowledge comes. Swamiji has said, take out 5 ideas and try to make it in practice in your daily life. Then you are more wise than a man who knows every information of a library. Library contains thousands of books. Every book contains so much information. But what information?